Hi, I'm Emil, the practical engineer, and today I'm making this bread cutter. Perfect square. All these parts cut so I can glue and nail them together now to form the base of the machine. There are a couple of gaps in between the parts, for example here. And before I'm gonna paint it, I'm gonna fill these gaps with some wood filler so that when I'm done painting, it looks really smooth. I painted the whole frame and I put it outside to dry. So in the meantime, I can work on the knife block. I have these four pieces of metal that will hopefully cut the crusts off, so I have to make knives out of it, and I have to drill some holes in it. I'm gonna start by the holes before I put any sharp edges on this. This is the knife block and it will push down on the bread like this, but I think you need to do more than that to remove the crust. So it has these overhanging pieces to cut all the way till the end, and in here there will be a square of the sandwich, but when you cut the crust it stays there. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make little sort of fingers that will push the crust outward after cutting it. So the idea is that this whole thing moves up and down, but in between the place where you push and this there are some springs. So first you push it down and the knives cut the bread, and then when you're pushing it all the way down you push all these little fingers out, pushing the crust away. The knife block will be hanging on this piece of wood by some tubes that will be on here, so this can still move up and down to push these things. to drill the holes. I'm gonna put this aside for now and continue with the base. Paint is all dry, so I can move on. What I need to do with this is there need to be a linear guide here for the holder that holds the bread. So you can push it under the knife, and then there needs to be a linear guide in here as well, so you can put the knife up and down. This is the tray for the sandwich, so I'm not gonna make it out of plywood, I'm gonna use some nice beech wood for it. Before I'm gonna mount the slide in here, I first need to put the bread holder on the slide. So I'm gonna screw this in place and then I can mount it. Next step is to mount the cutter mechanism. And to do that, I need to mount this linear guide onto the back panel over here. Now this is all together. I have the knife assembly that can move up and down, and I have the place for the bread that can move backward and forward. So you can put the bread here, move it safely under there, and then this can move up and down. But I'm not gonna move it up and down like this, so I want to make a handle for it. And I made these holes here so I can put an axle through, and I need to have a connection between the axle and this. Let's start with that. This piece is the piece that connects the handle to the cutter. Only thing is, I still need to make a handle to it. So I'm gonna drill a big hole here, and then with some threaded rod and some aluminum tubing, I can make a nice handle. So let's drill a hole, cut some threads, and then make the handle. I have all the parts for the lever made, so I can assemble it now. For some of the parts, I 3D printed them, such as this part that fits really nicely over this hexagon. I cannot really drill a hexagon hole, so it was a lot easier to print it. Seems to work. So let's get some bread and try it. It's in there. It's a nice square, but I cannot get it out. Look! Look, it worked. No more crust. Only thing is, it stays in there. I had to do two small changes to get it to function better. First thing I did is I changed the spring in here, because when you pushed it down, the fingers moved out a little bit too quick, and that's controlled by the force of the spring there. Second thing I did is I put a sponge down here, so when you cut it and put it back, the sponge pushes the bread out instead of the bread staying here. Other than that, nice machine. Too bad. It actually cuts it and leaves a perfect square. Perfect square. If you like this video, you'll probably like this video over here as well. Check out my Patreon page down there, and don't forget, dare to experiment and have fun creating.